Well, smart study techniques include two important things in them. The first one being that you read something very smartly and you revise smartly. Now, in this video, I will take you through three important levels of reading that will help you revise faster and retain your information better for a very long amount of time. Hi guys, and welcome back to my channel. I am Dr. Noor Saira, an endodontist and a part-time YouTuber. Well, if you are new to my channel and if you haven't subscribed yet, please subscribe and hit the notification bell icon so that you're notified every time I upload a video. Well, these three levels of reading has helped me revise information faster, better, and also retain the information for a longer duration. Apart from which, this technique also helps me make notes that is customized and important notes from different important sources into one place, which further helps me revise better and helps me ace in my exams. Well, I call this technique the CFM technique, that is consumption, filtration, and master notes making. Let's move ahead to understand what is the first level. Now, the first level, which I call as the consumption, well, what I do here is that I pick up a topic and I read it from end to end like a story without paying much attention or emphasis to all the important details, and I read it with a very light head. Now, what I basically, my idea here is to get a gist of the information. I try to create a thought process of the topic that I'm reading, because this topic that I'm reading is new to me. So it's important that I create a framework in my mind or get a gist of what I'm actually trying to read. For example, if I'm trying to read about the dendrogenous cyst from the odontogenic tumors, so I will just read it as an information, beginning to understand, okay, this is also called as a follicular cyst. This is the most common odontogenic developmental cyst. It occurs more commonly in the third molar region. What is the pathogenesis? So I'm trying to build a story in my mind. So this is my idea of the first level of reading. Now, what happens here is that the mind is trying to create a thought process. So I have consumed the information, I've consumed that entire topic which was there in the first or two pages. Now, my mind does get a little exhausted, so I tend to take a 5 minutes break to allow the information to settle down in my mind. So this is the first stage of reading. I move on to my second stage of reading, that is, I call this as the filtration stage. Now, the intention of the filtration stage is that I have already read the topic from beginning to end, and now I know what is there, what information is actually present in that two or three pages, and where the important information is actually located. So in the stage of filtration, I start locating or start filtering the important information that is present. For example, dendrogenous cyst. Now I know that dendrogenous cyst is also called as the follicular cyst. Now, for this second name of dendrogenous cyst is an important information, and so I mark it or I highlight it. Similarly, I'll go ahead and then mark and highlight that this is the most common developmental odontogenous cyst. What is the most common location? That is the mandibular third molar area. What is the most important pathogenesis? All this I mark and I filter the information. So when I'm highlighting this or when I'm marking this with the help of a pencil, this helps me with two important things, or this gives me two important results. The first one being that since I'm reading this information for the second time and I'm marking the important information, this information is getting reinforced into my mind and reinforced into my brain. And hence, what happens is this is reinforcing my long-term memory. The second important thing that's happening here is, since I'm marking and I'm filtering out the information here, when I come back and read it again, I know exactly what to read, and I'm saving my time, and this helps in revision, and this does help me in reinforcing the information in my mind. So this is the important second level. Now, you can always go a step ahead and you can always mark the keywords like a circle, or you can square them out. For example, under dendrogenous cyst, you can mark or make a square around the follicular cyst, that's also called as a follicular cyst. And dendrogenous cyst can develop from ameloblastoma. Mark it there. So these kind of things. Now, what happens is, these keywords that you mark or these keywords that you highlight basically tend to form a picture memory in your brain. Now, so every time you remember the chapter, or every time you remember that I have read Dendrogyrus cyst here, you will have a picture in your mind that, oh, I remember marking follicular cyst. So it's hence also called as the follicular cyst. It is the most common odontogenic cyst, that is a developmental odontogenic cyst. So that picture, that keyword will always flash in your mind. And this is the importance of picture memory. I have spoken more about picture memory and memorization techniques in my another video. I will link it below and you can always go back and watch that for further understanding of other memorization techniques. This is how you will filter out the information. So what happens as an end result of filtration is that you have all the important information in one place. Well, if you are somebody who likes to stick to one material or one subject or one book for a subject, and you don't like to refer multiple books, then you can always skip to step number 3. But if you're somebody who likes to make notes from different books, or you like to study and take information and collect information from different books, or if you're studying from 2 books, I would prefer that you finish these 2 steps from the other book also. So you know you have the gist from 2 important books, you have the filtered information from the 2 important books, and then you can move on to step number 3, that is master note making. So now that you have filtered information and you have marked all the important things and you have highlighted all the important things, you can simply jot them down in your notebook. And since you are writing these important and significant things from 2 or 3 important material into one place, you're customizing your notes, and you have all the important information about that topic from 2 or 3 important books into one place, I call this as the master notes. And the end result is of this master note is that you have all required important information from 2 or 3 books in one place. How does this help you? This helps you save time when you are revising the next time. It helps you put lesser efforts, and hence there is more retention because you're revising your own customized notes, which is written in your own language, in your own handwriting, with your own thought process. And hence it gives you more results in the exam. Why? Because it's like you're revising 2 or 3 books information at one time because you have your custom notes. And why did this happen? Because you followed a 3-step technique where you read out the gist, you filter out the information from 2 or 3 books, and you jotted it down in your book. And when you near your exams and you're wanting to revise, you revise your notes. And when you revise your notes, it's like you're revising 2 or 3 books, which probably people who haven't done it before will not have the same amount of information. And hence you are way ahead in the exam, and hence you perform better in the exam. This is a technique that I applied, and it definitely gave me results. It gave me significant and consistent results over a period of time, and I aced in all of my exams in my university. If you would like to know how to make or how to write down your master notes, what are the different type of note-taking techniques which will probably ease your life, which will help you revise better, that will help you create picture memory, ace in your exams better, I've made a separate video on that which talks about the different systems of note making. I will also link that down below or somewhere here, and you can always go watch that. Well, I hope this video has been beneficial to you and helps you out for your exams. And do follow my 3 levels of study technique consistently. It will definitely bring about results. Thank you for watching the video and have a good day. And if you haven't subscribed to my channel yet, go ahead and subscribe it. For more such videos, please like, share, follow and subscribe my YouTube channel. You can also follow me on Instagram. Have a good day. Thank you.